Rumours have begun to circulate that all but confirm the 3000 series GPUs will all have the hash rate limiter introduced after the 11th of May. But will this introduction of the hash rate limiter increase your chances of picking up a 3000 series GPU? And what should you do if you already have a 3000 series GPU? Let's find out. Hi guys, and welcome back to the Epic PC channel, and today we are talking about the planned expansion and reintroduction of the Ethereum hash rate limiter on Nvidia GPUs. Now, cryptocurrency mining is all the buzz right now, and it's easy to see why, with one single 3080 being able to produce over $5 worth of profit per day. Now, this has introduced large-scale mining farms which use hundreds of 3080s, and pictures have leaked online of these specific operations. This obviously has exacerbated the issue of supply for these specific 3000 series cards, and this isn't helped by the fact Taiwan is being hit by a massive drought, and this is impacting the production of these chips. As well as that, the COVID-19 epidemic has resulted in a huge push for more electronics as consumers are sitting at home and want to play games and use their computers. So this has created a real supply issue from Nvidia and the other chip manufacturers. Nvidia's solution to hopefully put the cards back into the hands of gamers was to reintroduce their hash rate limiter and expand it across the entire 3000 series lineup. This excludes the RTX 3090, which is earmarked for end of life anyway, with lackluster sales of Quadro cards from Nvidia. Obviously, Nvidia doesn't want this, and many workstations are opting for an RTX 3090 over a Quadro card because of its price point and VRAM performance. The RTX 3060 was the first card to hit the market with this hash rate limiter, and Nvidia also introduced the CMP range of cards for professional miners at the same time. Not surprisingly, with the amount of money at stake in cryptocurrency mining, it was just a matter of time before someone hacked this unhackable Nvidia driver that they introduced. And Nvidia did claim it was unhackable through a series of handshakes between the silicon and the BIOS. But most surprisingly of all in this story is Nvidia themselves were the ones that accidentally hacked it by releasing a beta driver version for the RTX 3060, which resulted in the hash rate limiter being lifted. A big oopsie for Nvidia and a unanimous head slap from both supporters and objectors of the hash rate limiter in general. Love it or hate it, Nvidia is doubling down on their efforts on the hash rate limiter, and the new silicon is expected to be received by board partners such as MSI, Asus, and Gigabyte on the 11th of May. So around a month after that, we should be receiving these cards on the shelves for gamers. Now, they will come under a new SKU identifier, and that's already been confirmed for the RTX 3060 cards, with them being called the GA106302 GPU, making Nvidia's whoopsie on the beta drivers obsolete. But of course, Nvidia, if you first fail, try again. Just don't say something is unhackable, especially if you're going to hack it yourself. Talk from board partners indicates that each of these boxes will have a unique identifier on them, either a sticker or a completely new box design to indicate that they are the new batch of GPUs. Now, obviously, board partners don't want to get sued for selling a card that was once mineable, but now is unmineable. So they're making this move to make it clear to you guys that these cards are the new batch. So what's going to be the impact on the GPU market? Well, in our opinion, it will make harder to find cards such as the RTX 3080 and RTX 3060 Ti much more likely to be available to you. That's because these cards are fabled by miners for their low price point and high efficiencies compared to the RTX 3070 and 3090. That being said, there are two main issues in supply that will not be solved. And the first being the COVID pandemic increasing demand for electronics, and the second is the drought in Taiwan. So the MSRP of these 30 series cards will still be extremely high. If you already have an RTX 3000 series card, what should you do with it? Well, the prices of these 3000 series cards that are still mineable will likely stay pretty high because the remaining miners will have to fight over the last batches of these cards. So if you are thinking of selling it, you can sell it at a premium, but this introduction of the hash rate limiter will likely increase the prices of these cards. So if you want to hold on to it for a few months and see if the price increases, then feel free to do that as well. And if you are a scalper of these cards, then I'd highly recommend sticking away for it and letting gamers have them. You don't have the deep pockets of miners available to you, and they won't sell like the RTX 3080 and RTX 3060 Ti did when it initially released. So if you do have back orders, I'd highly recommend cancelling them. Thank you guys so much for checking out this quick news update from the Epic PC channel. If you like the content, then feel free to like and subscribe, and also comment down below what you think this will do to market availability. Well, do you think it will improve or it will stay the same? As always, you can check out our website for more in-depth reviews and news.